Hi, hello, what's up? Welcome back to the channel if you're returning, and if you're new, welcome. Today's gonna be a different video than normal because today I'm not singing a song because 3 weeks ago I was diagnosed with vocal nodules, so I don't know if it's because I haven't been able to sing or what. I just have the urge to change my hair up. This is my natural hair. I've never colored it. And summer's kind of coming to a close, so I was like, you know what, maybe I will try to go darker. And I was like, you know what, maybe I'll just dye my hair my boyfriend's favorite color, black. I know. And then, so I did the thing, I jumped on TikTok and terrified myself, and everyone's like, with the semi-permanent stuff, everything leaves your hair green and blue and like, makes sense because science. But I just decided to go to Sally's instead of just like freaking myself out. I was like, I'm gonna go to Sally's and talk to a girl and see if there's a way. Cause first of all, I've tried to do my ends like the rose gold with overtone and stuff, but I've never bleached my hair, so it didn't stick. So I was like, one, is it gonna stick? And then two, is my hair gonna turn green? Cause I don't want it green. So I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go to the store and ask the girl at Sally's. So I did get like a darker one that will look black, but it does have blue undertones. But then she was like, if you dye your hair like a reddish color first, it'll help it blend better. So I was like, okay. So I ended up getting the Strawberry Leopard, which is the Sally's brand, I believe, in Merlot. And then, not today, but in the future, I'm gonna do the shade color over it that will turn it black. So I'm gonna go red first and then black. Hopefully it stays. I have like a limited amount of time because I have to go to work today. So we're gonna try this out on my virgin hair and see what happens. Now I don't know what I'm doing. I was like, do I need anything else? And she got me this little bowl thingy. I think that you just put the dye stuff in there. And then she got me some gloves and then this cute little pink brush to go. So I'm scared. And then also I'm wearing a black t-shirt. Shout out to my friend Michael Saldana, repping the merch with the black t-shirt. So that way I don't stain anything. I have a hair tie and some clippy clips to clip my hair out the way. It's one of those little, what are these, rat tail combs or whatever? I don't know, the like really skinny ones that are easy to part your hair with. And of course, the handy dandy hair tie. Wish me luck. I'm gonna brush out my hair, put my gloves on, and we'll see what happens. I'm kind of scared, but this is the before. Also, I like just put shimmers in my hair that are like perfect for my natural color. So we'll see what happens when it blends with this. So it just says to put it in your hair, leave it for what, 30 to 45 minutes, I think. This says 20 to 30 minutes, but I'm gonna do like 45 minutes and then rinse it out in the shower and we'll see what happens. So wish me luck. All right, and the bottle says not to mix with developer or anything. So it just says to apply it right into here. And I'm also sitting on a black towel on the floor so I don't stain the carpet, but I'm just sitting in front of my big mirror. Oh, this smells really good. Oh, this smells real nice. All right, I'm just gonna squeeze it into, it looks so weird. I don't know how much of this I need to use, probably all of it, but I'm just gonna squirt some in there and then go from there. Yup. All right, time to put the gloves on. I'm scared. Here we go. All right. Do the thing. Who am I? What is wrong with me? It's okay. It's okay. Nothing's wrong with me. I'm perfect the way I am. Also, have you streamed my new song, I'll Try? If not, you should. It's out on all platforms. I'll Try by Samantha Taylor. We're gonna brush. It says to put the hair into four sections. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be like left, right, bottom, and top. So that's just what I'm gonna do. Some part down the middle. We got a nice little part down the middle. I'm just gonna put this half into a ponytail. I really hope I have enough time to get ready for work. And then I guess I'll just do like the top and the bottom half on this side. Yo, we're cute. We're looking real cute. Look at us. I'm gonna brush it out one last time. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, it smells so good. No turning back now. I probably should have done underneath first. That's okay. This feels so weird. Obviously, I'm not a professional. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just experimenting because I'm bored. And I also, when it comes to my hair, I got real commitment issues. Like, it's crazy that I even cut my hair a couple months ago. And people ask me all the time if I miss my long hair. And like, not really, because it'll grow back. Like, it's already growing out. Like, it's grown out at least an inch since I cut it. I wonder what Rob's reaction is gonna be. Like, he's always like, you can do whatever you want. That's my boyfriend. He's always like, you can do whatever you want. It's your hair and blah, blah, blah. Because I told him I was thinking about doing my hair black, but he didn't know I was gonna do red first. Like, the only person in the world that knows I'm doing this at this moment is Lucas. That's our little one. And he's just like the same as his dad. He's like, you can do whatever you want. I don't care. I love you. What's she doing, Ari? Hi, puppy dog. I can't pet you or else you're gonna turn colors with me. And if you run around, you're gonna get this stuff on everything. All right, let's do it. This section's next. Oof, look at that color. Bye-bye, this color. Sorry, this color. You'll be back soon. You're just gonna be hiding underneath. It's not gonna damage you. You'll be just fine. Like, a lot of people change up their look all the time, and I'm just like, I'm scared. I feel like the gold shimmers probably will look cool with the red hair though too. So like, I'm not upset that I put shimmers in my hair recently. I think it'll look pretty cool. All right, so it looks like I have all my hair covered. I really hope I do anyway. But I think it's time to let it sit. And while I'm letting it sit, I think I wanna try and take a wipe, like a makeup wipe or something, to my face and try to start getting this stuff off my skin, cause that looks so rough. Looks like I got attacked or something. But I'm gonna try to get some of this off and then set a timer for I'll set a timer for like 45 minutes. I'm so scared, but excited. I wanna know. I really hope it sticks. And I really hope I saturated all my hair. I think that I did. I'm gonna let this sit in this cute little bun for 45 minutes, and then I'm going to rinse off in the shower, and I will show you guys what it looks like. I'm excited. Okay, bye. All right, so I just got out of the shower and towel dried my hair, and this is what she's looking like. I will say, like, I didn't use shampoo yet. I just rinsed it out with cold water, and I'm gonna use shampoo after I get home from work tonight. I will say, like, the water was constantly pink coming out. Like, I washed my face and my body after I tried to rinse my hair, and there's still pink water coming out. And I should have, I think I missed a spot, like, right here and right here, but that's okay. I can always do that like tomorrow. I don't have time today. But I would recommend keeping like a darker towel or a black towel for after the shower. I usually use a white towel, and that's all I had in the bathroom with me. And look at this. This is forever my hair dyeing towel now. But yeah, this is what it looks like for now. It's still wet. So I'm gonna do my makeup for work and let it air dry, and I will show you guys that. And then I'm gonna end the video probably tomorrow, because like I said, I'm gonna wash it with shampoo when I get home from work tonight. And then I'll show you what it looks like tomorrow after it air dries overnight after using shampoo. But so far I think it's really cute. Yeah, I was so scared, but now I think it's cute, and I think the gold shimmers are perfect with it. Okay, makeup time. All right, this is my hair with my glasses. It's still not dry, it's still wet, but I have makeup on. My glasses are reflecting the light.
Ari just dropped her toy on my face.
Lucas is in here trying to scare me. But Lucas said he likes it, and it's so sweet.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to my future YouTube video. I will show you guys what my hair looks like tomorrow after I actually wash it with shampoo, and we'll see what's left, but so far I love it.
I'm okay. Under the bed.
Hasta mañana. Good morning, guys. It's actually afternoon now. It's just about lunchtime, but this is my second day hair. I actually washed it after work last night, shampooed it, and this is the color that's left. And I'm honestly super happy with it. I wasn't sure how I'd feel with the gold shimmers, but I feel like the colors definitely blend really well. It stayed incredibly well on my hair. Like I said, I have virgin hair. I've never lightened it or colored it or anything, and I don't remember if I mentioned it or not, but I had tried to use overtone, like the rose gold, for like brown hair, and it didn't stick on my hair at all. So I'm actually super impressed at how well the color stayed in. I'm not sure how long it's going to last. Like, they say it doesn't last as long on virgin hair as it does on bleached hair or lightened hair. So I'm curious to see how long this will last. This is my first time actually doing any kind of color. So if you want to keep up with how long it lasts, follow me either here on YouTube. I say follow, subscribe here on YouTube, follow me on Instagram, and it'll be obvious how long this lasts. But one thing that I did want to mention, I didn't get like super, I don't know if you could tell, but I didn't get as close to my roots as I would have liked, so I may go back in. I used almost the whole bottle, but I still have some left. So I might go back in and just touch up my roots, but that's fine. Like I said, this was my first time doing it, and I'm really proud of how well I covered all my hair. Another note is that when I just rinsed it with cold water, there was so much pink coming out of the water in the shower, and it never stopped. So when you get out of the shower, use like a darker towel if you have one, because I totally stained one of my white towels, but that's okay. And then also when I washed my hair with shampoo later, it was still pink. Like, anytime my hair is wet, pink keeps coming out. Like, I thought for sure after I shampooed, I'm like, I think I just washed it all off, because there's still more coming out of my hair. But I've just noticed that more pink just comes off when it's wet. I did blow dry my hair because I was like, if my hair is bleeding pink whenever it's wet, I need to dry it before I lay down and go to sleep, because as you can see, I have white blankets and I really don't want to stain them pink. So I did blow dry my hair. And that's all I've done to it. I woke up with it like this after sleeping on it blow dried. Yeah, my blankets are still white, so we're all good there. So yeah, I have no idea how long it's gonna be bleeding color. If any of y'all have ever used the Strawberry Leopard brand, let me know if it ever stops, or if it's like just this color, or what's gonna happen. I don't know. I will say, I definitely did not picture myself doing such like an edgy look. I had no idea what the color was gonna be, because I didn't pre-lighten my hair or anything. And I know like the shades can kind of depend on what your starting hair is. And I thought it was gonna be like either darker or like leaning more towards red versus like a pinky purple, but I honestly really like it, and I didn't think I'd be able to pull off something like this. So it's definitely a little confidence boost, and like I said, I never thought that I would have been able to pull off a look like this before. And in my opinion, I feel like I'm rocking it. So yeah, and that also leads me to my next question in my head, was I wanted to do the red so that I could transition and have this underneath when I wanted to go more of like a black. So I'm like torn. I'm like, do I keep it this color because I kind of like it, or do I move forward and try out with the black? Also, I have no idea what the colors are gonna fade like. So it's like, do I leave it like this for a while and kind of see what color it's fading into, and then still maybe put more in and then go back with the black? Or do I just give it just a little bit of time, enjoy the pink for a minute, and then put in the other color? I'm not sure. But like I said, if you've tried products like this before and you have any tips or advice or any knowledge on how these colors may fade out, please, please let me know. But yeah, this was super fun. And if you're still sticking around, I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you had questions for yourself, I hope maybe this answered something, or maybe you just had fun watching it. But yeah, this was a cool little switch up. And also a couple closing notes. They might not be totally relevant, but like I said, I did have a song come out I do have vocal nodes right now, so I'm not able to perform and do my cover videos here on YouTube, but I do have a brand new original out. It's only been out for a few weeks. It's called I'll Try. It's on all streaming platforms, and I will leave a link to it below if you want to check that out. That would be so cool. It's a song about following your dreams and your goals through all the obstacles and ups and downs in life, and I really hope you can find a sense of inspiration from it. And I really loved writing it, and I love singing it, and it's actually helping me through this rough transitional period of trying to heal my nodes and while I'm on vocal rest and all that fun stuff. And then another thing, since I do have the vocal nodes, I noticed there's not that many people on YouTube that talk about their personal experience with it. And I was thinking about maybe documenting like parts of my journey, and because I have a lot of friends that are DMing me that are also singers that have been through it, but when you're going through it, you don't hear that many people talking about it. So it seems not like taboo, but it almost seems like there's just a sense of comfort from my friends reaching out to me saying that they've been through it. And so I was like, well, maybe I should document my journey through it and my steps to recovery so that maybe it can bring some comfort to anyone else who may go through this in the future, because I never would have thought. I thought it was a much more serious injury than it actually is too. So on that note, me and my pink hair are gonna go have a great day, and I hope you have a beautiful day with your beautiful self, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.